confirmed. Your anaconda is en route to the Flecky EGQ-DB47-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are just over 64,000 light years from home. One out of 9 bodies have been scanned. Refueled. Moon 6A is a notable icy body with an incredibly inclined orbit. Buddy 6A contains large deposits of carbon. Body 4A has large deposits of carbon and selenium.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is in transit to the Flecky ERM-IP43-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel at maximum.
Frameshift drive charging.
Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is traveling to the Flecky EGU-NB40-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
9 bodies remain to be scanned here. Fuel at maximum. Body 2A contains large deposits of carbon. Body 6A contains large deposits of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is en route to the Flecky SF-LD9-2 system. This is your first visit to this system. This star is remarkable with an unusually high solar mass of 1.2 times sols and higher than average surface temperature. As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. 3 out of 16 bodies have been scanned. Refueled. Planet 5 is notable, with pristine metal-rich and rocky rings. This body contains high levels of germanium and tellurium. Body 4A has high levels of arsenic. Planet 6 is notable, with a pristine icy ring. This body contains high levels of carbon. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 6C has high levels of carbon and selenium.
System scan.
Planet 7 is extraordinary, with an incredibly high mass at well over 19 times Earth. An extremely high radius of well over 17,000 kilometers, an extremely high surface temperature of over 620 Kelvin, and a pristine icy ring. This star system has every element that may be required to boost the range of this ship. Exploration class, green. Body 1 is a recommended mapping candidate.
Frameshift drive charging.
Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is heading to the Flecky SO-YB 34-0 system. This is your worst visit to this system. Fuel tanks are at 78% capacity.
Fuel scooping.
1 out of 9 bodies have been scanned.
Fuel scooping complete.
Fuel at maximum. Planet 2 is a notable rocky ice world with an extremely elongated orbit. Planet 1 is a notable rocky ice world with an extremely oblong orbit. Planet 6 is notable, with an unusually high radius of over 11,500 kilometers. Body 5A has high levels of carbon and selenium. Planet 7 is a notable icy body with an unusually high radius of over 12,000 kilometers.
Frameshift drive charging.
Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is en route to the Flecky SV-DB32-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels are at 78% capacity.
Fuel scooping.
3 out of 24 bodies have been scanned. Maximum fuel. Body of 5C has large deposits of sulfur and carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body of 5A has large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body of 5B has large deposits of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains large deposits of carbon. Planet 6 is a notable class 1 gas giant with pristine metal-rich and icy rings. planet BC 1 is an interesting bimetal content world with an extremely oblong and incredibly inclined orbit and an unusually high radius of over 9,500 kilometers. Planet 4 is a notable rocky ice world with an extremely high mass at 3.8 times Earth and an unusually high radius of well over 10,000 kilometers. Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is in transit to the Flecky ENL-FC14-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels at 76%.
Fuel scooping.
1 out of 9 bodies have been scanned in this system.
Fuel scooping complete.
Maximum fuel.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Welcome, everybody.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is heading to the Cereith with MR-CV26-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels at 79%.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete. Fuel scooping complete.
Your Anaconda is now fully refueled.
Frameshift drive charging.
Oh, way to go. About to check out some ice crystals. Somebody reported it. I'm going to go confirm it.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is in transit to the Cereith through the XF-JB22-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel tanks at 76% capacity.
Fuel scooping.
3 out of 20 bodies have been scanned in this system. Refueled. This body has large deposits of carbon and selenium. planet C7 is notable, with an incredibly elliptical orbit. Planet C6 is notable, with an incredibly elongated orbit. Body of 3 contains large deposits of selenium.
System scan complete.
This star system holds every element available on planetary surfaces. Exploration class. Gold.
Yeehaw, still didn't find a damn thing. Go look it.
Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is en route to the Siri Ifua GQ-GC10-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels now at 75%. Commander. Two out of its bodies have been scanned.
Fuel scooping complete.
Your anaconda is now fully refueled. Planet 2 is notable, with a pristine icy ring. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 2B has large deposits of sulfur, carbon, phosphorus, and selenium. Body 2D contains large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body 2C has high levels of carbon.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Yo, Nate, what are you doing?
Jump in progress. Your anaconda is in transit to the Siri Ifua YD-KC8-1 system. This is your first visit to this system. One out of 9 bodies have been scanned in this system.
Feed your race.
Maximum fuel.
That's funny. Not me. I've been up since 6:30 this morning. I've been bored all damn day, so I figured I'd play this. Finally made it out to Beagle Point. Now I'm headed back. But I'm going to go out and check out these ice crystals that someone has spotted. They reported it, so I'm going to go and confirm it. Figure it's on my way back anyway, so what the hell. Damn, somebody's blowing up my phone. What have you been doing all day, anything? Yeah, I'll show you what they look like. That's what they look like. Crystalline shards. That's what I'm going to go check out. That's where I'm on my way to now. Oh, you're leaving for Dallas tomorrow? Oh, that's cool. Oh yeah, they're always adding shit.
In progress. Your anaconda.
It's actually been in the game for a while.
The XY-SD3-0 system.
I think for maybe a year.
This is your first visit to this system.
But yeah, we got like 6 different types of Thargoids now.
Jumps left. Fuel reserves at 79% capacity.
Yeah, we got 6 different types of Thargoids now.
Maximum fuel.
We've got a Codex now. Oh, do you? Yeah, they've done a lot of adding to it. We've got six different types of Thargoids. We've got all kinds of different anomalies. Got a Codex now. Got a different kind of scanner now. Got different kinds of mining equipment. Because before, remember how you used to use your lasers to do the mining? Well, now you actually have, they're like drills. They have bombs on them. It's where you can blow apart the asteroids now. So yeah, they've added all kinds of cool shit, and they actually show you what else they got. Oops. They have, oops, wrong button. They actually have training now. They have training simulations, challenging scenarios, training videos, all kinds of cool shit. See, they never had that before. For new people that are just getting into the game. That way they know how to use some of the new stuff they've added.
Planet B5 is notable. With an extremely high surface temperature of well over 1,000 Kelvin.
But remember how you used to be able to, you had to go to each planet to scan them? Well, now we got this thing here. As soon as we come out of the system, slow your speed all the way down, and then hit your button that you find your key to, and you can scan the system. You don't have to fly out to each planet now.
Moon B2A is an exceptional rocky body with an extremely inclined orbit, an unusually high radius of around 2,500 kilometers, and an unusually
that's my voice
high
attack
gravity
going
0.33 times Earth. Body B2A contains
Waterworld
deposits of arsenic. Planet B2 is notable with terraformable conditions.
Damn, two water worlds. Yeah.
Planet B4 is notable with abundant liquid water. Planet B3 is a notable water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water.
We have probes now that we can shoot them at the planets.
B2, B3, and B4 are good candidates for mapping.
Holy shit! 82,000 light seconds. Holy crap. Oh, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, we'll go up to 2. We'll go out to 2, 3, and 4. Hey, Lucky. How you doing? So I figure since I'm heading back to the bubble, since I left Beagle Point finally, went to Colonia, went to Sagittarius A, went to Beagle Point, now I'm on my way back to the bubble. Then I gotta go to one of the material traders, because I'm damn near maxed out on all my minerals and stuff. Trying to get back to the bubble. Other than that, I'm doing pretty good. Besides, I'm taking this long cruise right now because there's two water worlds out here that no one has scanned or mapped. So I'm going to go out and map them. Got me a couple Earth-like worlds a while ago. I got so much freaking data right now, it's just unreal. It'll probably take an hour to turn all that damn data in. But I'm going to go out right now. I'm on my way back. I'm going to go out. Someone reported crystalline trees on a planet, so I'm going to go out and confirm it. No, I don't. You mean the auto docking? Yeah, I have that. I don't do the auto takeoff, but I do the auto landing or the auto docking. Sometimes I use it, sometimes I don't, but I have that module on my ship. I have 3 ships, I think. 3 or 4. I don't use the takeoff shit. I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with the landing either. It's just some of the stations I go to, depending on what it is, depends if I use it or not. I don't know. That's why I play on PC. Mouse and keyboard, buddy. Damn. Light seconds. Holy shit. Whoops. Wrong button. Damn it. I can't remember what keys I got binded up to this. Oh well, don't matter. But change my damn key binds.
Shit.
I'm getting there. 29, 28, 27. Yeah, I'm going to redo my key binds because I've got certain keys bound to it that, shit, gotta change them. Oh well. What's new? I know in December we've got a big update coming on this, and then they're putting in carriers. I think they said the second quarter of next year. They were supposed to do it in December, but they pushed it back again. Lurking alert, lurking alert. I hear you, Anubis. How you doing, man? Oh, that's cool. Haven't seen you in a while, so I didn't know how you've been. I don't know how they're setting up the carriers, but everyone's collecting money right now because they're going to be really, really expensive. Something like $200 billion. And they're supposed to have a better jump range. Rumor has it that if you haven't been there, you can't jump to it. So, but my Anaconda here has got a little over 70. So I've got this in here set up pretty good. All my other ships are like 50, 60. Which is fine with me. That's why I've been doing all this exploring and stuff. Yeah, well, I've got over $300 million right now, so I'm not really too concerned about it. Well, I'm trying to get back so I can turn in all this data. Last time I turned it in was when I was in Colonia, and I've already been out to Sagay and up to Beagle Point. Now I'm on my way back, so yeah, I got a lot of data. Please don't make me laugh. You need to start playing more. Now they got this in-game currency. It's called ARK. Right now I'm sitting at 136. You have a daily. Is it daily or weekly? I think it's weekly. 400 of those things. In-game money. You need to play more, man. That's all I can say.
Surface scanned by 50%.
All I can tell you, you need to play more. I know. Trust me, I know all about it.
Surface scan complete.
Surface map is complete. Efficiency bonus awarded. Planet B2 is a medium gravity terraformable high metal content world. This planet has low levels of active iron lava flows at the surface. The dense atmosphere is composed primarily of nitrogen with an average surface temperature of 276 Kelvin. Buddies B3 and B4 are also good mapping candidates.
Now I'll go do these two water worlds and we'll continue. Yeah, that's my voice attack. That's EDDI. It tells you everything about all the planets and everything. I got some profiles on it that I use. Helps out a lot. Like I can drop my landing gear by voice. Cargo hatch or cargo scoop, I mean, everything. That voice attack program was like $10. Oh, slow your ass down, Bubba. You know, when you're looking for materials on the planet, you know, whenever you're scanning them, it'll tell you what's on it. That's mainly what I use it for. But I've got most of my, like, iron and all that stuff. Nickel, all that crap. I got a lot of that shit fucking maxed out. There's only certain planets that actually have the ones I'm missing. Yep. I did that one day with one guy I play with every once in a while. That was pretty fun. I was on my way out to Beagle Point. I think I was almost in Colonia and he wanted to see what it was like out there in Colonia. So I brought him on board. He got to see what Colonia was. That was pretty fun. Yep, that was pretty fun. Had one fucking probe take off on me. Okay, I'll be here.
Surface map is complete. Planet B3 is a medium gravity terraformable water world. I am detecting low numbers of active silicate vapor geysers. There is a thick water rich atmosphere with an average surface temperature of 407 Kelvin. Body B4 is also a recommended candidate for mapping.
Well, that's where I'm going now, stupid. Hey Anubis, I finally got my affiliate. Damn. Hours away. Damn, long way. Hey, as long as she's happy, it's all that matters, man. I know it's hard to let them go, but as long as they're happy. Oh man, Anubis, I've got some new games I've been playing. Oh my lord. A couple of them are horror games. Well, one of them is a horror game, and the other one is kind of a horror game, but kind of it screws with your mind. So it's in the year 2084. It's called the Observer. Observer. I haven't played this game like this here for a long time. I figured it was time to start playing it again. It might be.
Surface scan complete.
Map is finished. Efficiency bonus granted. Planet B4 is a medium gravity water world. Sensors detect low levels of active iron magma flows near the surface. The dense atmosphere is composed primarily of carbon dioxide with an average surface temperature of 461 Kelvin. You have mapped all worthwhile bodies. Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is heading to the FLECTO-TC6-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
You fucking honk.
Fuel scooping complete. System scan.
Maximum fuel.
Smell Canadian bacon. But there are 60 jumps.
Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is en route to the CIRI-EFUA-TQ-GB10-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 59 jumps to go. Fuel levels at 81%.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete.
Just lucky charms.
Fuel scooping complete.
Maximum fuel.
I like it. Just lucky charms. Oh, you changed your name.
Frameshift drive charging.
Cool. You gotta change it to Irish cream.
Progress. Your Anaconda is traveling to the CIRI-EFUA-DZ-SC3-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping. System scan.
Oh.
Sequence start is notable, with higher than average density. As you can see, it emits an orange red light.
Well, tell your dad they'll be sending that money back.
Fuel at maximum.
I couldn't get them to do what they were supposed to do with my account, so I went ahead and declined it, and they'll be sending it back. So just let them know. Since I never see them online anymore, I couldn't tell them.
Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is traveling to the FLECTO-TC2-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels are at 78%.
Fuel scooping.
Main sequence star is notable, relative to similar class K stars, with higher than average density. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. 2 out of 25 bodies have been scanned. Refueled. Planet 2 is a notable Class 1 gas giant with pristine rocky and icy rings.
Well, this hopefully I can find something good here.
Of carbon.
Looking for some biological signatures.
Moon 2C is a notable icy body with an unusually elliptical orbit. This body has high levels of carbon. Moon the 2B is notable, with an unusually elliptical orbit. Body the 2B has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body the 2D contains high levels of sulfur, carbon and selenium. Body the 2E contains high levels of sulfur and carbon. Planet the 3 is notable, with a pristine icy ring. Body 1C contains high levels of carbon. This body has large deposits of carbon and selenium.
I don't need carbon, I got full of that.
Body 1AA contains very large deposits of carbon at 25.9% and large deposits of sulfur and phosphorus. Body 1A has large deposits of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has large deposits of sulfur, carbon and phosphorus.
Oh. Yeah. Well, them ice wolves don't have any.
Planet B3 is notable, with an extremely high surface temperature of over 538 Kelvin. Planet B4 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of well over 457 Kelvin.
Nothing there.
This star system holds every element that may be required to augment an explorer's range.
Shit, coming into a neutron.
Green.
Next jump's a neutron star.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is in transit to the Ciri Ethua KG-YD6 system. Caution, neutron star detected. This is your first visit to this system. This neutron star is uncommon and notable, relative to similar class than neutron stars, with an extremely high average density of over 369 quadrillion kilograms per cubic meter. Planet 1 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of well over 462 Kelvin.
Boost my jump range to 288 light years. It's 70.
Frame shift drive boosted by 400%.
Buddy. Uh, 281.
Frame shift drive charging.
Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is traveling to the PyroUQNP-EC25-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 55 jumps to go. Your Anaconda is now fully refueled. telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is traveling to the Pyre UQJJ-GC24-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
God, my legs hurt.
Fuel levels at 81%. Starta is notable, with an unusually old age of around 12.5 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. Starta is remarkable with an unusually high solar radius at 0.66 times Sol and higher than average surface temperature. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. Your anaconda is now at maximum fuel capacity. Destination confirmed. Your anaconda is in transit to the Pyre UQCS-JC22-1 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels now at 87%. Maximum fuel.
Frameshift drive charging.
Yeehaw.
Destination confirmed. Your anaconda is traveling to the Pyre UQXQ-LC21-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. This main sequence star is notable.
Ooh, 25.
With an unusually high solar radius at 0.64 times Sol. As you can see, it emits an orange red light.
I don't know what they have here.
One out of 25 bodies have been scanned here.
Will there be anything interesting here?
Maximum fuel. This body has large deposits of carbon and selenium.
3.9% on germanium. I fucking need it too.
Body 1B contains large deposits of carbon and selenium.
3.7%. That one. What's biological signal?
Body 1BA has very high levels of carbon at 25.0% and selenium at 4.6% and large deposits of sulfur and phosphorus.
Okay, pretty full on all that shit.
Moon 3C is a notable icy body with an extremely elliptical orbit and an extremely high surface temperature of nearly 503 Kelvin. Moon 3D is a notable icy body with an extremely oblong orbit and an incredibly high surface temperature of just over 463 Kelvin. Moon 3A is a notable icy body with an extremely high surface temperature of nearly 544 Kelvin. This body contains large deposits of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body to B has large deposits of carbon. Body 2B contains high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has high levels of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus. This body contains high levels of carbon. Body to D contains high levels of carbon. Planet 5 is remarkable, with an unusually elliptical orbit, an extremely high surface temperature of nearly 1,500 Kelvin, and a pristine icy ring. Planet 4 is notable, with a pristine icy ring. Body 4B has large deposits of carbon and selenium. This body has high levels of carbon. Body 4B has high levels of carbon.
Oh, what's geological stuff?
This body has high levels of carbon and selenium.
Frameshift drive charging.
Oh, what's geological stuff, but no biological stuff? Shit.
Progress. Your anaconda is traveling to the PyroUQTJ-IB9-3 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
11 bodies.
1 out of 11 bodies have been scanned in this system. Refueled.
Corrupted nebula, it looks like.
Moon 3A is notable, with an incredibly inclined orbit.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Next. Next.
Jump in progress. Your anaconda is en route to the PyroUQKY-QC18-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are now around 62,500 light years from home.
2,000 light years.
Refueled.
Oh, yeah, I've played this game this long in a long time. That everything is geological, not biological.
Body B3 has high levels of arsenic. Planet B5 is notable, with an extremely high surface temperature of around 1,500 Kelvin.
System scan complete.
This system contains every element required to augment the range of this ship. Exploration class. Green. Progress. Your Anaconda is traveling to the PyroUQTM-UC16-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
Starby is notable, relative to similar class than stars, with higher than average surface temperature. As you can see, it emits an orange red light.
Really close to that nebula.
3 out of 22 bodies have been scanned.
But look and see what nebula that is.
Fuel at maximum. Body of B2B has high levels of carbon.
Who cares? Only carbon.
Body of B2A contains high levels of carbon and selenium.
Asshole's like a thermal.
Planet of B3 is exceptional, with an extremely elongated orbit, an extremely high mass at around 10.5 times Earth, and an incredibly large radius of just over 15,000 kilometers. Planet B1 is notable, with a pristine rocky ring. This body contains large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body of B1B contains large deposits of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains large deposits of carbon and selenium.
Can't get over all of
body of B1C contains high levels of carbon. body of B1D has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body of B1F has large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body of B1G has large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body of B1H contains large deposits of carbon. Moon of B1JA is a notable icy body with an unusually inclined orbit. This body has very large deposits of carbon at 25.8% and high levels of sulfur and phosphorus. Body of B1J has large deposits of carbon and selenium.
Oh, here we are.
Moon of B1K is a remarkable icy body with an unusually inclined orbit and a pristine icy ring.
No, I found what I wanted.
Progress. Your Anaconda is traveling to the Pyre UQXF-WC50-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. This main sequence star is notable, with higher than average surface temperature. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. 10 bodies remain to be scanned here. Maximum fuel. Moon 4A is a notable icy body with an incredibly inclined orbit. Body 4A contains high levels of sulfur and carbon. Planet 6 is a notable icy body with an incredibly inclined orbit and an unusually high radius of around 11,500 kilometers. This body has large deposits of carbon and selenium. Planet 3 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of just over 406 Kelvin.
Got that in there. 48. Then I'll check out that ice crystal.
Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is traveling to the Pyre UQRO-ZC13-1 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 47 jumps left. Maximum fuel. Body 1 is a recommended candidate for mapping.
Good. Better luck with these smaller systems.
Planet 5 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of just over 381 Kelvin. planet Oa is a remarkable water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water.
System scan complete.
Body Oa is a recommended candidate for mapping.
Yeehaw.
Your Anaconda is traveling to the PyruQLN-BC-13-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel reserves at 75% capacity, Commander. This star is notable, with higher than average density. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. Two bodies remain to be scanned.
Yep.
Maximum fuel. Planet 2 is a remarkable gas giant with ammonia-based life with an incredibly elongated orbit and an extremely high mass at nearly 646 times Earth.
Where's he at? All by himself. There you are.
System scan complete.
You're all by yourself.
Frameshift drive charging.
Oh shit. Let's check this. Fuck. Wrong button.
Your Anaconda is heading to the
PyruQLN-BC-11-1
system. This is your first visit to this system. Starda is notable, with an unusually high average density. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. 10 bodies remain to be scanned in this system.
Welcome everybody.
Refueled.
Now here, check out this crystal. If I reported it, I'm gonna go verify it. There, I'm trying to find some biological signature. Yep, that'll be geological. Geological. There.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Under.
Progress. Your anaconda is heading to the PyruQZP-GC10-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 44 jumps until arrival.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete.
Ain't nothing there.
Fuel at maximum.
Frameshift drive charging.
Jump in progress. Your anaconda is en route to the PyruQNN-SV17-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Your anaconda is now at maximum fuel capacity.
Frameshift drive charging.
Next.
Destination confirmed. Your anaconda is en route to the PyruQZU-XB14-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete.
Your anaconda is now at 100% fuel capacity. Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is en route to the Pirate Ride UH-VC5-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are just over 62,000 light years from home. Fuel reserves at 74% capacity. Commander, this star is exceptional, with an unusually high solar radius at 0.7 times Sol. Higher than average surface temperature and high brilliance. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. Fuel at maximum.
Frameshift drive charging.
You get there pretty quick when you ain't got a skin nut.
Two.
destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is en route to the Pirate Drive PB-XC4-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 40 jumps remaining. Fuel reserves at 73%. Starda is notable, with an unusually high solar radius at 0.65 times sols. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. Brown Dwarf C is notable, with higher than average density. Three bodies remain to be scanned.
Yeah.
Fuel at maximum.
System scan complete.
Geological.
Frameshift drive charging.
Ooh, class G.
Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is heading to the Pirate USS-UC2-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel reserves now at 80%. Commander.
Fuel scooping.
Ooh, 16.
15 bodies remain to be scanned. Maximum fuel. Planet 3 is exceptional, with an unusually high radius of well over 12,000 kilometers, an extremely high surface temperature of nearly 594 Kelvin, and a pristine icy ring. Planet 2 is notable, with pristine rocky and icy rings. Body 2B contains high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has high levels of carbon. Body 2C contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 2E contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 2F has high levels of carbon. Body 2D contains high levels of sulfur, carbon and phosphorus. Body 1D contains large deposits of germanium.
System scan.
Body 1D has large deposits of germanium. Progress. Your anaconda is in transit to the PyroUQHG-YD0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
Starkey is notable, with an unusually high solar radius at 0.64 times sols. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. 23 bodies remain to be scanned.
Yeehaw, 23.
Refueled.
Go find some. Might be some biological in here.
Planet 6 is notable, with terraformable conditions. Planet 5 is a remarkable water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water at the surface. Planet 3 is notable, with potential for terraforming. Planet 4 is notable, with terraformable conditions. Body B1 has large deposits of iron, nickel, manganese, vanadium, cadmium, niobium, and yttrium.
Almost looks like a freaking egg.
Body B5B has high levels of carbon. Body B5A has large deposits of carbon. Body B5C contains high levels of carbon. This body contains high levels of carbon. Body B4A has large deposits of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of carbon. This body has large deposits of carbon. Body B4D has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has large deposits of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus. This body contains high levels of carbon.
System scan complete.
This system has every element that can be found from surface prospecting. Exploration class, gold. Bodies the 3, the 4, the 5, and the 6 are recommended mapping candidates.
3.
Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is in transit to the PyroUQQG-YB0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels at 79%.
Fuel scooping.
Strata is notable with an unusually high average density. As you can see, it emits an orange red light.
Refueled.
Your anaconda is in transit to the CAUQ-J-XC-28-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
One out of its bodies have been scanned. Maximum fuel.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Jump in progress. Your anaconda is traveling to the CAUQHI-BD-13-3 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 35 jumps to go.
Fuel scooping.
Staria is exceptional, with an unusually high solar mass of 0.98 times sols. Higher than average surface temperature and high brilliance. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. Body BF1 is a good candidate to map. Maximum fuel. Planet BEF1 is an interesting water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water. planet BC4 is notable, with an unusually inclined orbit.
System scan complete.
Body DEF-1 is a good candidate to map.
Such a long That's cool. Set of twin sons. It looks like there's a third one going around. Pretty cool. Damn thing. When I scanned it, but they didn't map it. Don't really need the data, but I'll take it. Discover it, be the one map. Welcome, everybody. Hey, Josh. I'm doing it all right, I guess. What are you up to? How you been?
Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Map is now finished. Efficiency bonus awarded. Planet EEF-1 is a medium gravity terraformable water world. The very thin atmosphere is composed mainly of oxygen with an average surface temperature of 278 Kelvin.
Frameshift drive charging.
You have mapped all interesting bodies.
Yeah, I've been up since 6:30 this morning. My alarm went off at 3 and I said, hell with it, roll and went back to sleep. Well, thank you.
Jump. Progress. Your anaconda is traveling.
I feel like going back to bed.
MV-CC26-0.
Had a doctor's appointment yesterday.
This is your first visit to this system.
Yay, that was.
You have 34 jumps left. Maximum fuel.
It's just one of those things, I guess. Hell, I've been playing this damn thing here, streaming this thing for 2 hours.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is heading to the QAUQFE-GC24-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels are now at 76% capacity.
Well, have you been playing that gold mine one?
With an unusually high solar mass of 0.54 times sols, an unusually high solar radius at 0.74 times sols, lower than average density, and high luminosity. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. 4 out of 11 bodies have been scanned here.
Utah will be out in November. I posted it on your page.
Now at maximum fuel capacity.
I saw it today, so I posted it on your Facebook page. Or they were going to release it in November. Yeah. Hope I have the money to get it. Need to get the other ones too.
Planet 2 is notable. With an unusually oblong orbit.
Oh, did they? What was the update? Anything interesting?
Planet 1 is notable with an unusually elliptical orbit.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw that article.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is traveling to the QAUQZ-QB46-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are now nearly 61,500 light years from home. You have 32 jumps to go.
Fuel scooping.
7 bodies remain to be scanned here.
Fuel scooping complete.
Refueled.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Trying to get back to the bubble. Scanning planets.
Four,
got 61,000 light years to go.
Anaconda is in transit to the US.
And my ship only jumps 70 at a time. System.
This is your first visit to this system.
Every system I go to, I scan the planet.
Main sequence star is notable, relative to similar class M stars, with higher than average density. As you can see, it emits an orange red light.
Frameshift drive charging.
Main sequence star is notable, relative to similar class M stars, with higher than average density.
What I do in this screen, I scan all the planets.
It emits an orange red light. Your Anaconda is now at 100% fuel capacity.
Yeah. This game's had a lot of upgrades.
23 bodies have been scanned.
The old system, you used to have to go to each one of the planets and scan them, and now you did it this way. A lot faster.
Planet C5 is a notable icy body with an unusually elliptical orbit. Moon the B3A is notable, with an extremely inclined orbit. This body contains high levels of carbon. Body of B2A contains large deposits of carbon. This system contains every element that may be required to augment an explorer's jump range. Exploration class. Green.
I'll show you where I'm at. There's Beagle Point I just left. See all the blue dots over here? Way down here. There's the bubble. So yeah. I got a long way to go. So there's Sagittarius A. I'm clear to fuck out here. Yeah, I got a long way to go. Like I said, 61,000 light years to get back to the bubble. Get back to my home terminal.
Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is in transit to the CHAUQUP-GD10-3 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 30 jumps until arrival. Fuel reserves are at 74% capacity. Planet 1 is an interesting bimetal content world with an unusually high radius of around 9,500 kilometers and an extremely high surface temperature of around 4,500 Kelvin. Body 4 is a good candidate to map.
Yeah, my Anaconda jumps a little over 70 light years, and I'm 61,000 away, so yeah, a long way to go. And when I hit each system, if I haven't been to it, then I'll go in and scan everything. I went out to Colonia, is notable with and then extremely went to Sagittarius A, and then I went out to Beagle Point. Kelvin. So I haven't turned in no data since I left Colonia. So, yeah, I got a shitload of data to turn in.
Is a notable rocky body with an extremely high surface temperature of over 953 Kelvin.
It'll take an hour at least for me to turn in all this freaking data I got. If not longer.
Moon 3A is notable with an extremely elongated orbit. Body 3A has large deposits of tellurium. Moon 3B is notable with an extremely elliptical orbit. Is an exceptional water world with an unusually high mass at 8.9 times Earth, an extremely high radius of nearly 16,500 kilometers, and abundant liquid water. Planet 5 is a notable Class 4 gas giant with a pristine rocky ring. Moon 5D is a notable rocky body with an incredibly elliptical orbit. This body has large deposits of germanium and arsenic. Moon 5C is notable with an incredibly oblong orbit. Body 5C contains high levels of arsenic and tellurium. Body 5B has large deposits of arsenic. Planet 6 is extraordinary, with an extremely oblong orbit, an incredibly high mass at around 12.5 times Earth.
I'm almost up to 1,500 hours on this game. Yeah, I played quite a bit.
This system contains every element that may be required to augment your Anaconda's jump range. Exploration class. Green. Body 4 is a recommended mapping candidate. Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is en route to the CHAUQAE-PC-19-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. 21 bodies remain to be scanned here. Fuel at maximum. Planet 2 is interesting, with an unusually high mass at just over 390 times Earth and pristine rocky and icy rings. This body contains large deposits of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus. Body 2A contains large deposits of carbon.
Okay, I'll see you later.
This body has very
have a good
high
night
levels
at work.
Of selenium at 4.5% and large deposits of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus. Body 2G has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has very large deposits of selenium at 4.4% and high levels of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus. Body 2E has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of sulfur and carbon. Body 3D has high levels of carbon. This body has high levels of sulfur and carbon. Body 3D has high levels of carbon. This body has large deposits of carbon. Planet 1 is notable, with pristine metal-rich and rocky rings. This body has large deposits of arsenic. Body 1E has very high levels of tellurium at 1.5% and large deposits of germanium and arsenic. Body 1B has large deposits of arsenic. This body has large deposits of tellurium.
System scan complete.
Body 1D has high levels of tellurium. Planet 4 is an exceptional icy body with an incredibly high mass at just over 13 times Earth, an extremely high radius of well over 15,500 kilometers, and a pristine icy ring. This star system contains every element that can be found on planetary surfaces. Exploration class, gold. Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is heading to the CHAUQCN-SC17-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel at maximum. Planet 1 is notable, with a pristine rocky ring. Body 1D contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 1B has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 1C has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 2B contains high levels of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon. Body 2C contains large deposits of carbon and selenium. Body 2D contains high levels of carbon and selenium. This system holds every element that may be required to augment your Anaconda's range. Exploration class, green. Destination confirmed. Your Anaconda is en route to the CHAUQWL-UC16-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
Starty is notable.
Damn twin stars.
Average surface temperature. As you can see, it emits an orange red light. 29 bodies remain to be scanned.
Warning, temperature critical.
Refueled.
Get mass burnt. And heat sink.
Synthesis complete.
Shit.
Moon CV4A is notable with an incredibly inclined orbit. This body has high levels of tellurium. Planet the BCD3 is exceptional, with an incredibly high mass at nearly 19 and a half times Earth, an extremely high radius of nearly 17 and a half thousand kilometers, and an extremely high surface temperature of just over 520 Kelvin. Planet the BCD2 is a notable Class 3 gas giant with a pristine rocky ring. Planet the BCD1 is notable with a pristine rocky ring. This body contains large deposits of germanium.
System scan complete.
This system holds every element that may be required to boost your anaconda's jump range. Exploration. Green. Jump in progress. Your anaconda is heading to the Chaouqnz-XC14-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
Brown dwarf is notable, with an unusually high solar radius at 0.37 times sols. Maximum fuel. This body has very large deposits of selenium at 4.4% and high levels of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus.
System scan complete.
This star system holds every element required to augment the range of this ship. Exploration class. Green. Jump in progress. Your Anaconda is in transit to the CHAUQTR-ND6-1 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are just over 61,000 light years from home. You have 25 jumps remaining.
Fuel scooping.
Buddies 1 and 2 are good candidates for magging.
Fuel scooping complete.
Refueled. Planet 1 is a notable high metal content world with terraformable conditions. Planet 2 is notable, with abundant liquid water at the surface.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Buddies 1 and 2 are good candidates for magging. Obtained. Your Anaconda is in transit to the CHAUQTR-DC-12-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel reserves are at 82%. Commander.
Fuel scooping.
Six bodies remain to be scanned here. Your Anaconda is now at 100% fuel capacity.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is en route to the CHAUQTR-SC-11-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Your anaconda is now fully refueled. Planet 1 is notable with a pristine rocky ring. Moon 1e is a notable rocky body with an unusually elliptical orbit. Moon 1f is notable with an unusually elliptical orbit. Planet 3 is a notable icy body with an unusually high radius of just over 12,000 kilometers. Planet 2 is a notable gas giant with ammonia-based life with pristine rocky and icy rings. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Your anaconda is heading to the CHAUQUP-GC10-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Yeehaw!
Fuel levels now at 80%. Commander.
Fuel scooping.
Maximum fuel.
22 more jumps. Find out about the ice crystals. And scan everything on the way.
Planet 6 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of well over 439 Kelvin.
This is a period of ice.
This body has large deposits of sulfur, carbon, and phosphorus.
You know that ship, I'm right maxed out on it.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Going to a keystar.
Destination confirmed. your anaconda is heading to the CHAUQRY-SD3-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Current location is well over 16,500 light years from home.
Fuel scooping.
Buddies 1, 2, and 3 are recommended candidates to map. Fuel at maximum. Planet 3 is a notable water world with abundant liquid water at the surface. Body 3A has high levels of germanium. Planet 1 is an interesting water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water. Planet 2 is notable, with abundant liquid water.
System scan complete.
Buddies 1, 2, and 3 are recommended mapping candidates. Obtained. Your anaconda is en route to the CHAUQGC-MC7-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 20 jumps to go. Fuel reserves are now at 79%. Refueled. Planet 1 is a notable Class 3 gas giant with an extremely inclined orbit. Jump in progress. Your anaconda is heading to the CHAUQNS-UV2-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Current location is over 16,500 light years from home.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete.
Refueled. Buddy 7A has high levels of carbon and selenium.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Progress. Your anaconda is en route to the CAUQIM-WD1-2 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel at maximum. Planet 2 is a notable icy body
system
with an extremely elliptical orbit.
Frameshift drive charging.
Planet 1 is notable with an extremely oblong orbit. Jump progress. Your anaconda is traveling to the CAUQLX-UC2-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 17 jumps remaining.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete. Fuel scooping complete.
Refueled.
Frameshift drive charging.
Your anaconda is traveling to the CAUQHR-WC1-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You are around 60,500 light years from home. Maximum fuel. Planet 2 is a notable rocky ice world with an extremely elongated orbit.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
your Anaconda is traveling to the CHAUQDA-D3 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 15 jumps remaining. Fuel reserves are at 77% capacity. 1 out of 9 bodies have been scanned.
Fuel scooping complete.
Your Anaconda is now at 100% fuel capacity.
Frameshift drive charging.
This body contains large deposits of carbon. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. Body to B has high levels of carbon. Body to C contains large deposits of carbon. Obtained. Your Anaconda is en route to the Pyrethwa SN-XC28-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel levels are now at 90% capacity, Commander.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete. Fuel scooping complete.
Refuel. Obtained. Your Anaconda is en route to the Pyrethwa MM-ZC27-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Maximum fuel.
Frameshift drive charging.
Hey, Knight, what you up to?
Telemetry obtained. Your Anaconda is heading to the Pyrethwa GL-VC27-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Fuel at maximum.
About 6 foot. Okay, smart ass. When you gonna grow up? I got you by about 4 inches. Frameshift drive charging. Oh shit. I'm about tired. I think I'm getting old, man. I'm gonna be 50 in about 3 days. No, 2 days. Yep, 3 days.
Jump progress.
This is Elite Dangerous.
Is traveling to the Firel through the FV-EC25-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
One out of 18 bodies have been scanned. Refueled. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body has large deposits of carbon and selenium. This body has high levels of carbon. Body 5C contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Planet 3 is notable, with an extremely high surface temperature of over 587 Kelvin. Moon 4F is a notable icy body with an extremely elliptical orbit. Moon 4E is notable with an extremely oblong orbit.
System scan.
Planet 1 is a notable water world with abundant liquid water at the surface.
I gotta go
body
there.
Is a recommended candidate to map.
Gotta go there because whoever scanned it didn't map it. Make more money. Yeah, it's a fun game. We got about 1500 hours logged into it. If you like space games, space simulators, you'll love this one. Because you can do like I'm doing, be an explorer, you can be a bounty hunter, you can be someone that runs cargo. I mean, there's just so many different things you can do. Be a miner. It's a fun game. This is how you map planets. Send off these probes. It'll scan the surface and tell you what's on it.
Mapping is complete. Efficiency bonus granted. Planet 1 is a medium gravity water world. Sensors detect high numbers of active water geysers at the surface. The super dense atmosphere is rich in argon with an average surface temperature of 337 Kelvin. All bodies of Enduras are now mapped. Obtained. Your Anaconda is traveling to the Pyre through the US-GC-24-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. You have 10 jumps to go.
Fuel scooping.
Starda is notable, with an unusually old age
of
over
28.5 billion years.
As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. Bodies a 2 and a 3 are good candidates to map. Fuel at maximum.
Big asses. Figure what they have been.
Planet V3 is notable, with an unusually elongated orbit. Planet V4 is notable, with an unusually oblong orbit. Planet 3 is a notable water world with terraformable conditions and abundant liquid water. Planet 2 is a notable high metal content world with potential for terraforming. Moon the 7A is a notable icy body with an incredibly inclined orbit. Body the 7A has high levels of sulfur and carbon.
And more.
This system holds every element that may be required to boost an explorer's range. Exploration class. Green. Bodies. The two of the three good candidates for mapping. Destination confirmed. Your anaconda is en route to the Pyria through a VN-IC-23-0 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Fuel scooping.
8 bodies remain to be scanned in this system.
Complete.
Your anaconda is now at 100% fuel capacity.
Planet
2 is a notable bimetal content world with terraformable conditions. Body 2 is a good mapping candidate. Telemetry obtained. Your anaconda is traveling to the Pyria through JB-FD-11-1 system. This is your first visit to this system.
Few more jumps, see what these ice crystals are.
Fuel reserves are now at 75%.
Fuel scooping.
This means sequence star is notable, relative to similar class K stars, with high brilliance. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. 2 out of 14 bodies have been scanned. Fuel at maximum. Planet 9 is exceptional, with an unusually high radius of well over 12,000 kilometers, an incredibly high surface temperature of over 459 Kelvin, and a pristine icy ring. This body has high levels of carbon and selenium. This body contains high levels of carbon and selenium. Body 8B contains large deposits of carbon. Body 8D has large deposits of carbon and selenium.
System scan complete. Frameshift drive charging.
Jump in progress. Your anaconda is in transit to the Pyria through LQ-NC-20-0 system. This is your first visit to this system. Buddies 1 and 2 are good candidates to map.
Fuel scooping complete.
Maximum fuel. Planet 2 is a remarkable water world with potential for terraforming and abundant liquid water. Planet 1 is notable, with terraformable conditions and abundant liquid water at the surface. Planet 6 is notable, with an incredibly high surface temperature of well over 400 Kelvin. Planet 4 is notable, with an extremely high surface temperature of over 484 Kelvin. Buddies 1 and 2 are recommended candidates to map.
Actually, I think that's right there where I'm going to call it quits. Everybody have themselves a good day. Out of here.